Hi, I'm Heather, one of the systems engineers here at Pessler. Today we're going to talk about the ticketing system in PRTG. Some of you may have seen that across the menu at the top and not really quite sure what it is. Well, we do have a ticketing system. I refer to that as a process flow for your alerts. For example, say disk space warnings. You may not want your phone blowing up for them, but you want to make sure they're dealt with, so you can use the ticketing system to keep an eye on it, as long as you look at the ticketing system. It's not a full-blown help desk ticketing system that you may use if a user calls a help desk, but it's going to help you utilize PRTG to the best in your environment. So why don't I walk you through it right now? All right, to access the ticketing system in PRTG, you come across the top to the main menu and hit tickets. So here you can look at your tickets, which is my tickets, all tickets, or to-do tickets. So for now, I'm going to just go into all tickets so we can look at them. Remember, it's not a full-blown help desk ticketing system. You have to have a ticket based on some kind of PRTG alert. Now, of course, you can open them up manually or the system can generate them themselves. So PRTG can create tickets if you do use them in notifications, or if you see an alert come in, you can open up a ticket itself. So, and I will go and look at that towards the end of this tutorial. So just to explain some of what you're seeing in here, these are the tickets generated by the system. I like to call the ticketing system a process flow, just a way for you to manage your alerts, maybe assign them to others, make sure you use them. You can sort them here by status, so you can see all, open, resolve, and close, because you can resolve a ticket and close a ticket. A resolve ticket marks that, okay, it's resolved, so whatever the situation is that, you know, may have caused it to go to alerts resolve, but the ticket itself is still open, so it could still be reviewed, and then, of course, it could be closed out later. Then a closed ticket is closed. So let's jump in here and take a look at what a ticket might look like. You could see here, you see the error message going down while it's here. Once you have a ticket, you can go in and edit the ticket. So if you want to add some comments here, you can do it, change the priority if you need to, assign it to another user or group in itself. Again, we can assign the ticket here based upon the edit button. If you just want to go and assign and do a quick comment, they give you an option to do that. Resolving the ticket puts it in that resolve state that I mentioned, and I could say, situation is now resolved, and then I could say, okay. And then, of course, too, even though I did put my resolved, if I want to go in and close it, I can close it. Once a ticket is closed, you can always reopen it if you need to. So let's go back to the main menu here. And you notice when I hit tickets, it's very blank here, so I have to select what I do want to see if I want to see the ticket. So if I go here, I can, of course, list my open tickets. If I want to look at just resolved tickets, we can see here, closed tickets you can go through. And then this is the one I just closed, and then I can go and look through all tickets as well. If you need to add a ticket, you can do it from the main menu. If you need to do that there, you can add a ticket that way. But it's going to be a little bit more complex because you're going to go through, you're going to browse your device tree to get the alert or object that you want to make the ticket about. Another way that's easy to open up a ticket, if I go in here and I select a sensor that's an alert, I can go to this menu here, and you can see at the top right hand, I can hit add ticket, and it's going to create a ticket. I could put the subject, DHCP error. I could choose who I want to assign it to, and then I could put my comment. And for me, this is a high priority, so let me change that there, and I can say okay. And then the ticket is created for the ticket queue. So that's one way of doing the tickets there. Let's go in and talk about some of the other types of tickets. I mentioned earlier we have the notification tickets. So as some of you recall, when you go into your notification templates, one of the ones you can do is tickets. All right, when you go into the notification templates here, you can recall that one of the means of notifications is assigned a ticket. It's this bottom one that you probably might not have used too much, but if you come in here and put assign a ticket as a means of notification, and then you can put what group you want to do it to, those notification tickets come in here. So if we add, I'm going to go to all tickets just so we have a broader view of tickets, and type That's this notification tickets. So these tickets were generated because I put that as a notification, and when I put a notification trigger, because when a state was in a certain state or a volume or threshold was reached for some reason, they generated these notification tickets. So keep that in mind. And like I said a few seconds ago, you could go and watch the tutorial notifications to get more information on that. But here is an example of the notification ticket. And again, we can edit, assign them. If you do use notification tickets, I always like to warn though, if a person doesn't come in and look at them, you don't know they're there as means of notification. So you do have to actively use the ticket system for them to have some meaning to you. But that is one of the other ways a ticket can be generated. Then the last category of tickets to be generated was the to-do tickets. The to-do tickets are created by PRTG itself. And let's go to all just so we see them in here. And here, that is when some sort of task in PRTG is done. For example, we could see auto discovery finish because auto discovery was running. A software update's available, report finish. So it's just a way of PRTG notifying you when it's doing something that you might need to do as well. One thing I did want to tell you with the priority list, the default priority is 2 stars. So you know if you don't go in and change the priority in tickets, it will always default here at 2. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on tickets. I hope it helped to put some just more, what's the word I'm looking for? Just some thought around it that you understand the process for, because I know it's probably one of those things that's kind of hidden in here and we don't talk about too much. So now you see why we have our ticketing system built into PRTG. If you have any questions, please email support@pessler.com and have a good day.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com and always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.